Yes, welcome to Maida Samaja. Dear students, this is the on class of biology. So today we have to be pointed out the topic tissues. Yes, we well know we are all the living organisms. All the living organisms are either single celled organisms or multicellular organisms. The example to the single cellular organisms are amoeba, bacteria, paramecium, etc. Example to the multicellular organisms, all the plants, animals, mushroom, all they are example to the multicellular organisms. The single celled organisms contain only single cell. Multicellular organisms contain many cells, billions of cells, trillions of cells are in multicellular organisms. In single celled organisms, either they are the prokaryote or eukaryote. Prokaryote means in a cell, true nucleus is absent. Prokaryote are the living organisms where the true nucleus is absent. Example, bacteria. Eukaryotic single celled organism, for example, amoeba, paramecium, euglena, unicellular algae, all they contain true nucleus, but they are single celled organisms. In single celled organisms, most of the functions are to be carried out within a single cell, because the single cell exposed to the environment, all the gases, soluble substances and other nutrients are moved and out by a simple diffusion process. We know that the diffusion is nothing but the movement of the molecules from the region of higher concentration towards the lower concentration. But in multicellular organisms, the diffusion process will not sufficient to meet all the functions. Why it is like? Because the name itself says the multicellular organisms contain billions of cells, trillions of cells. Then the diffusion process takes a longer time to carry out the functions. Then the chances is there, the tissues formation is very essential. Tissues are grouped together form organs. A set of organs led to form a particular organ system. For example, in animals, digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, excretory system, etc. Each system have a set of organs. For example, digestive system in human contains the mouth is an organ, esophagus is an organ, stomach is an organ, small intestine, pancreas, all they are the different organs of a common system. Come to one more organ system, transportive system or circulatory system, blood, blood vessel, heart. These organs are led to form a transportive system in human. These organs are formed by different kind of tissues. Sir, then what do you mean by tissues? You may ask the question. Yes, tissues are nothing but it is a group of cells with the similar structure and the function. Please concentrate, students. Tissue is a nothing but group of cells with a similar structure and function. Tissue level organizations not to be seen in single celled organism because they are single celled organism, but tissue is a group of cells. Then the tissues level can be seen only in multicellular organism. The group of tissues form organ, the group of organ form a common function with a particular system, organ system. Therefore the organs are formed by tissues. Tissue is a group of cells with the similar structure and function. Okay, we know that the biology has different branches, like the botany is nothing but the study of plants, zoology is nothing but the study of animals, microbiology is nothing but the study of microbes. As usual, the branch of the biology deals with the study of tissues and their organization in an organism is called histology. It is a branch of biology. The histology branch deals the study of tissues, how the tissues are formed, which kind of cells are present in the tissues, how they are organized, what the main functions of the each tissues, that are all studied in a separate branch of biology, that is nothing but histology. Once again, the branch of biology deals with the study of tissues and their organization in an organism is called histology. The plants and animals are the major multicellular organisms. Therefore, they need specific organ systems. So, each organ systems have a set of organs. These organs are formed by the different kind of the tissues. Of course, the plants and animals are the major multicellular organisms. But tissues in plants and animals are different to each other. The tissues of the plants are not to be found in the animal, and the animal tissues are also not to be found in the plant tissues. Let me see the differences between the plant tissues and animal tissues. Okay, come to the difference between the plant and animal tissues. The plant tissues require the cell energy compared to the animal tissues. Why the plant tissues require cell energy and maintenance? The plant tissue requires the cell less energy and maintenance because the plants are fixed to the one position. They will not move. The plants are fixed and they do not move. Growth is restricted only to the roots and the stem. And moreover, the plant tissues, most of the plant tissues are having dead cells. Some tissues are the living. All these factors enable to the plants that plant tissues requires the cell energy for their maintenance. But animals are more. Why the animals are move? They will move around to search for the food. Aharakkagi horata, mating, reproduction gagi horata, and for shelter, vasasthanakkagi horata. And moreover, the growth is uniform all over the body. All parts of the body will be grown. And almost all the tissues are living in animal tissues. Therefore, all these factors enable to the animal tissues require more energy for their maintenance. Why the animal tissues required more energy for their maintenance compared to the plant tissues? Because the plants do not move. They are fixed. The growth is restricted to the roots and the stem. Therefore, they need less energy for their maintenance. Okay, next we will move on to the plant tissues, classification of plant tissues. Of course, the plant tissues are found in only plants. Even the plant tissues are different, different kinds. Let me see the different kinds of plant tissues. Majorly, the plant tissues are to be classified into meristematic tissue and permanent tissues. Is there any difference between the meristematic tissues and the permanent tissues? Yes. If there is the difference, then only we have to be classified. Meristematic tissue is a plant tissue. The specialization of these meristematic tissues keep on divide to form the new cells. Then what do you mean by meristematic tissue? The plant tissue which is specialized to keep on divide by the cell division to form the new cells. Such a type of the plant tissue is known as meristematic tissue. Now we will come to the permanent tissue, the definition of the permanent tissue. It is also a plant tissue. Then how the permanent tissue is formed? If the plant tissues derive from the meristematic tissue gradually change. When they attain maturity, they gradually change into a permanent tissue. That means permanent tissues are the plant tissues derived from the meristematic tissue. Here, the general classification of the plant tissues, as we know that there are two types, the meristematic and the permanent tissues. Again, here the meristematic tissues classified into the apical meristems, because it's the meristematic tissue, lateral meristems, intercalary meristems. Now we will move on to the explanation on the meristematic tissue. Sir, what about the permanent tissue? That we will discuss in next topic. Okay, now we will move on to the meristematic tissue. We know that, as I already said, meristematic tissue is a plant tissue specialized to keep on divide to form the new cells. Now you have to be look up the general characters of meristematic tissue. We know that tissue is nothing but group of cells. The cells are must in a tissue. Then in meristematic tissue, cells are very small in size. The plant's meristematic tissue are very small in size and they have thin cell walls. Dear students, we know that in plant cell, the cell membrane is surrounded by one more layer, externally surrounded by one more layer, that is known as the cell wall. All the plant cells contain cell walls, but the animal cells do not contain cell walls. Since it is a plant tissue, the cells are very smaller inside, surrounded by cell wall. Thus, even the cell wall is very thin, made up of cellulose. Cellulose is a carbohydrate substance. All the cells of meristematic tissue contain large nuclei. The nucleus are larger in size. But the cells of these meristematic tissues have very small vacuoles, may be present or the vacuoles may not be present. If they are present, they are very smaller in size. Why the vacuoles may be present or may not be present in meristematic tissues? Because the photosynthesis will not be takes place in meristematic tissues. Therefore, there is no need to storage any materials inside the cell. Vacuoles are said to be storage house of the cell. There is no need to storage any materials in the cells of meristematic tissues. Therefore, the vacuoles are very smaller in size And between these cells, the cells of the meristematic tissues, no intercellular space. There is no space between the cells. Cells are closely packed to each other. They remain divide. The cells are having a capacity to divide actively throughout the life of the plant. They are specialized to keep on the divide to form the new cells. That is the feature. In plants, these meristematic tissues are present in the tips of the roots, berugala tudiyalli, stem apex, kandada mel tudiyalli, nodes of the stems. Then what do you mean the nodes of the, what do you mean by the nodes of the stem? ಒಂದು ಶುಗರ್ ಕೇನ್ ಇದು ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಗಂಟೆಗಳ ಥರ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ನೋಡ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕ್ಸೈಲಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೋಯಮ್ ಸರ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕ್ಸೈಲಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೈಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನ್ಸ್, ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೂ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಡೈಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಡು ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಡೈಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್? ಇಫ್ ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಒನ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಲೀಫ್, then it is called monocot plants. If the seed contain two seed leaf, then it is called dicotyledonous plants. For example, ragi, maize, wheat, etc. ivella monocotyledonous plants. Why they are said to be monocotyledonous plants? Nodi, ragi seed agli, jolada maize seed agli, matte wheat agli, ಅದನ್ನು ಎರಡು ಪೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸೀಡ್ ಲೀಫ್. ಅದೇ ನೀವು ಕಡಲೆ ಬೀಜ ತಗೋ, ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ನಟ್, ಅವರೇ ತೆಗೆದುಕೋ. ಇವೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಸಹ ಡೈಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ದ ಸೀಡ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಟೂ ಸೀಡ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡೈಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಯಾ, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ದ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಟಿಪ್ಸ್, ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಎಪೆಕ್ಸ್, ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ಸ್, ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕ್ಸೈಲಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೋಯಮ್, ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೈಕಾಟಿಲಿಡನಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಚ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್. ರೂಟ್ ಏರ್ಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತಲ್ವ, ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲವೂ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್. These are the general characters of meristematic tissue. Now, we are to be known the definition of plant tissues and general characters of plant tissues also. We will move on to the classification of meristematic tissues. So, dear students, we already known that the meristematic tissues are majorly three types: apical meristems, observe the diagram, intercalary meristems and lateral meristems. How these meristematic tissues are classified into two, three types? Based on the origin, location of the plant body and differentiation. On what basis the meristematic tissue is classified into three types? Meristematic tissue is classified into three types based on the origin of, location of the plant and the differentiation. Origin, yava mooladallide, ellinda adu yava cells inda udbhavavagta ide, elli ide matte yava reethi vyathyasagalannu hondide. Based on the origin, moola. Based on the location of the plant, plant na yava bhagadallide, and differentiation. ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಆ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸಗಳು ಹೊಂದಿದೆ. ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎಪಿಕಲ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್, ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಕೆಲರಿ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಎಪಿಕಲ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್. ದ ಎಪಿಕಲ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ರೀಜಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಟಿಪ್ಸ್ and stem apex. Root tips, berugala kela tudiyalli, stem apex, ಕಾಂಡದ ಮೇಲ್ತುದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸೋ ಯು ಆರ್ ವೆಲ್ ನೋನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ದ ಶೂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಶೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಲೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಅರ್ಥ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನ್ ಜಿಯೋಟ್ರಾಪಿಸಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಡೀಟೇಲಾಗಿ ಹೇಳೋಣ ಕಾಂಡವು ಮೇಲ್ಭಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಬೆಳೆಯುತ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತದೆ ಬೇರು ಕೆಳಭಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಬೆಳೆಯುತ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತದೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಸೊ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುವಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ The apical meristems, therefore, it is present in the root tips and stem apex at the height of the plant or length of the plant. Lateral meristems are also the meristematic tissue. It is also found around the radial portion of the stem and the roots. Suttalate, side galalli, idu ಲೇಟರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ದ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಡ ದಪ್ಪ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಸೀಡ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ದಿನಗಳ ನಂತರ ಆ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ದಪ್ಪ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಕೆಲವೇ ತಿಂಗಳ ನಂತರ ಇನ್ನೂ ದಪ್ಪ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಕೆಲವು ವರ್ಷಗಳ ನಂತರ ತುಂಬ ದೊಡ್ಡದಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಕೈಗೆ ಸಿಗೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೇಡಿಯಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ರೂಟ್ನ ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ಒಳಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ನ ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ಒಳಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದು ದೇ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ದ ಗಿರ್ತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಗಿರ್ತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಥಿಕ್ನೆಸ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ಇಂಟರ್ಕೆಲರಿ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಕೆಲರಿ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ They also have the specialized cells to keep on the division to form the new cells. These intercalary meristems are present at the base of the leaves. Yelagala thudiyalli and the base, kelabhagadalli. Ondu elayanna kittaga, veeledale kittaga nodi, agala iruttala, adu base. At the base of the leaves. And intercalary meristems are also add to the size of the internodes. ನೋಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಪ್ಯಾಚಸ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ವಾ ಆ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೋ ವೈಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಚ ಇದು ಬಂದು ಇಂಟರ್ ನೋಡ್ಸು ಆ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಪ್ಯಾಚಸ್ ಬಂದು ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ದ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಸ್ಟಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಮೆಚ್ಯೂರ್ ದೇ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯಲಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂಸ್ They gradually change into the permanent tissues. Before going to the permanent tissues, we have to conduct a simple experiment on meristematic tissues related to the root tips. Please, you observe
Study of the root tip of the onion. In this module, you will learn about tissues present in the root tip. Do you know how plants grow? Well, it is the continuous and active division of cells at the apex of the plant that results in its growth. Let us conduct an activity to study cells and tissues that help a plant to grow by observing the root tip of the onion. To study the growth in the root tip of the onion, you need two same-sized onion bulbs, two glass tumblers filled with water, and a pair of scissors. Let us now begin the activity. Take two tumblers filled with water and mark these tumblers as A and B. Now take two onion bulbs of the same size and place one in each tumbler such that only the lower surface of the bulb is in contact with the water. After that, leave both the tumblers undisturbed for 3 to 4 days. Observe the onion bulbs on each day to note the growth of roots. In case of tumbler B, since the roots have not been cut, the root tip continues to grow longer. This root tip is a region of growth. The root tip consists of a tissue called meristematic tissue, whose cells keep dividing and hence results in the growth of roots. While in the case of tumbler A, the root tip was cut, which resulted in the absence of the region of growth. Since meristematic tissue was absent, no cell division took place and hence the growth of roots stopped. From the above activity, it can be concluded that root tip of the onion has specific type of tissue called meristematic tissue, which causes the growth of a plant. In this module, you have learned root tip of the onion has a specific type of tissue called meristematic tissue, which causes the growth of a plant. Meristematic tissue is a group of cells that divides and grows continuously and hence causes a plant to grow.